What's up guys, today we are taking a break from the Mustang content and we are going to be working on my daily driver. This is my 2012 Chevrolet Impala LS and today we are going to be replacing the wheel bearing. Now this is a pretty simple job but I just wanted to make a how-to video on how to do it because if you were to have this done at a shop it would probably be around $350 to $400 after tax. And doing it yourself, you can save yourself about $300. The part itself is $100 and takes like an hour of your time. So I'm gonna show you guys how to get it done and let's jump right into it. Okay, first things first, I have the parking brake set inside the car. I'm also gonna place a brick behind the back tire just to make sure that the car doesn't roll at all. Safety is very important. I do have an electric impact, but sometimes it's not strong enough. So you guys probably wanna leave the car on the ground and use a breaker bar to break the lug nuts loose before you jack it up. You don't need to loosen them too much, just get them loose enough that you can rotate them when the car's off the ground. The next step is to place a jack stand under the car. I'm put mine under the subframe, and we're gonna lower the car down onto the jack stand. Now you probably wanna leave your jack under here, so I'm gonna jack it up just a little bit more, just so there's a little bit of pressure on the jack. So that way we have the jack stand and the jack in case one of them fails, we have a secondary backup. So now we're gonna remove the wheel off the car. I usually put the wheel underneath the car just as an extra safety measure. We do have the jack and the jack stand under there, but in case both of those fail, we'll have the wheel under there to catch the car if it falls. So now we are going to take off the caliper. There's two bracket bolts. One is on top here. There's another one on the bottom that's identical to it. I know you guys can't really see it that well. They are 15 millimeter bolts. We're going to take both of those out and the caliper will come off of the rotor. All right, the caliper is ready to come off. I'm just going to pull it off. And I'm going to use a bungee cord to dangle it from the suspension so we're not putting tension on the brake line. Just like that. At this point, we need to remove this screw on the rotor. It is a T30 Torx, so we will get this popped loose. And once that screw is removed, we can pull the rotor off and set it aside. All right, at this point, there's only two things holding the hub into the car. There's this axle nut right here that is a 34 millimeter, and then there's three bolts on the backside of the hub that are 13 millimeter. I'll try to get a view of those so you guys can see where they're at. This is hard to show on video, but this is one of the bolts right here. There's also one tucked up right in there, and there's one directly opposite on the other side of the axle that is the same as this bolt. That all three of those need to be pulled out. I'm gonna use my impact with a 34 millimeter on it to remove the axle nut. You can do this by hand, it's just going to take a while if you're using a wrench, so that's why I use the impact. That bolt was a little bit hard to remove because the axle shaft was a little bit rusty. If you guys need to, you can clean that off with a wire brush before you do that. I was able to just get it off the impact though, it was pretty easy. So before I loosen the bolts behind the hub, I'm going to use a hammer to break the axle free in here. There we go, and now we can take the nut back off. So the axle is actually now free in here. You can see it moves back and forth. And now the final step is just to get those three bolts removed behind and unplug the ABS sensor. I'll show you the ABS sensor real quick. It is right back here behind there. There's the connector for it. So we will just disconnect that, get the other three bolts out, and the hub should come out. A little side note, this connector for the ABS sensor, you're gonna wanna use needle nose pliers to squeeze this connector in here and then push it out because there's two little tabs that won't allow you to push it out otherwise. You will also need a 3-inch extension to get to the bolt on the right side and the bolt on the top. I'm using a combination of short and long 13 millimeter sockets to figure out which I need for each bolt. So just kind of trial and error on that, but you're gonna need a little extension. All right, I now have all three bolts out. The hub is not coming loose. This is pretty typical on cars that have a little bit of rust or just have some age. So I'm actually gonna have to use a hammer to break this loose. This is the old one. There's really no way to hurt it because it's just gonna go in the trash. So you can kind of hit it wherever you want since we're gonna be replacing it. I'm also gonna be using a sledgehammer instead of the normal hammer that I have because it has a little bit more weight behind it. So another thing just happened that's pretty typical on Impalas. The hub basically fell apart. So there's still like the back part of it in there. So this should have like a casing on it. So we need to get that out, obviously, to put the new one in. So I'm probably gonna try a couple different things. I'll let you guys know what works. All right, so I don't know if you guys just saw that. I was able to get a screwdriver in the middle here and actually just kind of pry against it. And that ended up coming apart. Now another thing you need to pay attention to is this connector actually slides through where the axle goes. So you can see it back there. So you might have to push the axle in a little bit to get that connector to come through the front. It's pretty hard with one hand, not gonna lie. But you guys get the idea. So you kind of just push that forward, push the axle inward, and pull on this connector. There we go, just got it out. So there's the back half of the hub. Now before we do anything else, you do want to get a rag with some brake clean or something similar and clean out this race in here because we want it to be smooth for putting in the new wheel hub. And considering these wheel hubs are wear items and on Impalas they go out pretty commonly, I'm going to be using a little bit of anti-seize inside of here to make it easier to get this out and the next time it needs to be replaced. Now make sure you don't forget your dust shield when you're putting this back together. This goes on first before the wheel hub. The cutout portion is for the where the brake caliper goes, and you can tell because there's your brake caliper bracket bolts go right here. So that's where the cutout portion goes. So we're gonna slide that on. We'll grab our wheel hub. We're gonna slide our connector through. Like I said, you kinda have to push the axle in to get this connector all the way through, so. That is what we're gonna do. It's a little tricky getting everything lined up, but once you push everything through where it's supposed to be, you can kind of get everything lined up. Make sure your bolt holes are lined up on there and just push the hub into place. Now, since I'm reusing the factory bolts, I'm going to be using a little bit of blue thread locker. This is good because, like I said, this is probably gonna fail again in the future. And I don't want these bolts to vibrate out, but I want to be able to get them out in the future. And all three of these bolts will get tightened down by hand, just to make sure that they're snug. Now it's time to put the axle nut back on. I'm going to use the same blue thread locker, but I'm actually going to put it on the threads of this, because I want to put a little bit of anti-seize on the outside, just to make sure that no rust builds up. Installation is the reverse of taking it apart, so we're just going to jump cut through this real quick. But the next step is to put the brake rotor back on. Now the caliper gets slid back on, and our caliper bracket bolts get reinstalled with some blue thread locker. We will torque the caliper bracket bolts by hand to make sure they're tight, reinstall the wheel, remove our jack stand, and lower the vehicle to the ground. Here is all the tools I used for the install of the wheel hub. A 19mm socket, 34mm socket, short well 13mm, deep well 13mm, deep well 15mm, 3-inch extension, 1/4-inch drive ratchet, 1/2-inch drive breaker bar, couple of hammers, a screwdriver, T30 Torx with a 1/4-inch ratchet, needle nose plier, anti-seize, and blue thread locker. So overall, as you guys can see, this is a pretty easy job. I hope this was helpful to someone or it saved somebody money from doing this themselves, aside from taking it to a shop. So you guys can definitely do this in your driveway with some common hand tools. Pretty easy job. If this helped you, make sure to drop a like down below. Consider subscribing for more videos like this and drop a recommendation for a video down in the comments. I appreciate you guys watching and I'll see you guys next time. Thanks.